Let's make one more tutorial in Autodesk Fusion. In this video, we will make this part here and animate this. So open your Fusion and let's go. The first step to create this part, we'll make the part number one, the base, okay? So the first thing that we'll make, we'll select the front plane and make this sketch. Here will be our midpoint. So we'll make this sketch here. We'll put the dimensions later, okay? So open your Fusion, go to create a sketch, select the right plane, select line, make a line here, make this sketch. Let's see the dimensions here. We have 38 here in the base, 23 here, 8 and 10 millimeters, okay? So go to dimensions here, 38, 23, 8 millimeters here, and 10 millimeters here. Okay, we made this. And here we have a chamfer here with 5 millimeters. So go to modify, select the chamfer, equal distance, select this edge here. The chamfer here is 5 millimeters, press OK. We made this, finish the sketch. Now we need to extrude this. We need to extrude this distance here, 20 millimeters. So go to extrude, select this profile. The direction here, select symmetric, measurement, whole length, and the distance here, 20 millimeters. Press OK. We made this. Okay. Now here we need to create this arc here. To create this, we use full round fillet. It radius here of 10 millimeters of radius. So go to modify, select the fillet, and the type here, select full round fillet, select this face here, and press OK. Let's check this. The radius here, 10 millimeters. Okay. We made this. Now here we have a fillet with 3 millimeters, this part here, okay? The fillet is 3 millimeters of radius. So go to fillet again, the type here, select fillet, select this edge here. The fillet here is 3 millimeters. Press OK. We made this. And we have one more fillet. Sorry. We have a fillet here in this corner and in this one, with 6 millimeters of radius. So select this edge here and this edge here, 6 millimeters of radius, and press OK. We made this, okay? Now we need to make this cut here. It is a rectangle, 20 millimeters by 8 millimeters throughout this cut. So go to create a sketch, select this face here, and select the 2-point rectangle, make a rectangle here, 20 millimeters by 8 millimeters. Okay. Go to constraint, select the coincident, select this point and this edge here. It is coincident. And go to dimensions, sketch dimension. The distance between this line and the midpoint here is 4 millimeters. Okay, finish the sketch. Go to extrude, select this profile here. The operation here is cut, and the extended here is all. Flip the direction and make this cut here. We made this. Okay. Now we have one more cut to make this, to make here, sorry. We needed to make this slot here. This slot, 8 millimeters by 6 millimeters, and the distance between the center of this slot here and the midpoint here is 17 millimeters, okay? So open the Fusion. Go to create a sketch, select this face. Go to create, select a slot, center to center slot. Make a slot here with 8 millimeters by 6 millimeters. Let me put the dimensions here, 8. The distance between this line here and the midpoint is 17 millimeters. Now we need to put this in the center. So the distance here, 4 millimeters, and finish the sketch. Now go to Extrude, select this profile, the extended here, select all, operation cut, and make sure that its cut is to the side and press OK. Sorry. We made this. Okay. Now go here in the bodies, select the body one, click here with the right button and create a component from this body. Rename this part one. Okay. Now we'll create another component. So let's create the part two. We'll make this sketch here. The first thing that we'll make here, we'll select the front plane and make this sketch. Okay. So let's create this. Hide this component, go to create sketch, select the front plane. And here will be our midpoint. So let's create this construction line here with 30 millimeters. Okay, so select line, construction line, click here at the midpoint, 30 millimeters. Press OK, remove the construction line type. And here, let's make this sketch, a line here, an arc with 5 millimeters of radius, and another line here. The distance between this line and the construction line is 20 over 2, so it will be 10 millimeters, okay? So select line, make a line here, make an arc here, and another line here. Make sure that this arc here is tangent with this line. Okay, go to sketch dimension. The distance here is 10 millimeters, and this arc here has 5 millimeters of radius. Okay, now let's create another line here, with 10 millimeters, and create this line here. This is this one. Let's create this profile. We'll put the dimensions later, okay? No problem. Okay, go to sketch dimension. The distance here is 10 millimeters and 5 millimeters. So here is 10 millimeters and here is 5 millimeters. And we have the distance here, 15 millimeters. So the distance between the center line here and this edge will be 7.5 millimeters. And the distance A here is a distance to 8 over 2. It will be 4 millimeters, but we use 3.5, okay? Or we can use 4 millimeters, no problem. So go to sketch dimension, the distance here, 7.5 millimeters, and the distance here, 4 millimeters. We made this. Now we needed to extrude this, and we will extrude this 8 millimeters. So finish the sketch. No, sorry. Go to create, select mirror. Select all this line here, the mirror line is this construction line, press OK. Finish the sketch. Go to extrude. The extended type, select the distance, direction, symmetric, measurement, whole length, and the distance 8 millimeters. Operation new body, press OK. And now we need to create this number 01 here. So go to create a sketch, select this face here. Go to create, and select the text and make a rectangle here, okay? The text here is 01. The 8 here, we can use 8 millimeters. And let press OK. We can move this a little bit here, okay? And finish the sketch. Go to create, select the emboss, the sketch profile, select this number here, the effect, select the deboss, and the face, select this face here, deboss, the dip here, select the minus 0.1 millimeters, 0.5 millimeters, sorry, and press OK. We made this. We can use 0.1, no problem. It will be more cool, okay? So we made this. Now, select the body tool here and create component from this body. Rename this to part 2. Show the part 1. We made this, okay? Let me add some color here, press letter A in the keyboard, fusion appearance, select a paint, glossy, this one will be blue, no, green and yellow here. Okay, now go to assembly, select the joint, and select this edge here, the center of this edge, and the center of this edge here, flip here. Now you don't need to flip, just rotate this 180 degrees. And the motion here is slide. And the minimum here is minus 5 millimeters. And the maximum here is 5 millimeters. Let's make a preview here of this motion and press OK. Let me animate this joint. So that's it. Here we finish our exercise, and thanks for watching. Subscribe my channel for more and see you in the next video. Bye bye.